Alright lads and lasses, my name is the Medic Goblin. Today I'm going to explain to you the film order, the story, the timeline, whatever you want to call it, of the X-Men films. But first of all, here is a clear, very clear diagram that explains it all absolutely perfectly. But anyway, let's get on with the video. Now, the reason why the X-Men films need so much explanation in the terms of their actual film order is because it is incredibly confusing. There's a lot of things going on, and I've spent the best part of a month trying to figure it out. I've been talking with my friends for ages. Until last night, I thought it was completely different. And today, after I watched The Wolverine, everything just changed for me. So today, I'm going to explain it very clearly. I'm going to go through all the films. Like, you know, for instance, the watch order, like which films you want to watch in the exact order. So the order through the films, because obviously there are different timelines. That's why it is so confusing. And I'm also going to be explaining like all the things that are really weird, like why is Professor X alive? Why is the initiation of Scott into the X-Men, or basically the school, like completely different in the Wolverine compared to the X-Men Apocalypse? All these kind of weird things and all these differences. And it's because basically there's two timelines. I don't explain basically the gist of it. So I think the best way to explain this is to use Microsoft Paint, right? But don't worry, I'll have some more cool pictures, you know, between this explanation. Right, so I'm just going to quickly check if the mouse cursor is working. Right, my mouse, whatever, is actually working. So I'm going to quickly draw the lines, you know, the timeline. Okay, don't worry about this too much yet, alright? And if any of you are seeing anything dirty like right now from this image, then you need to go and see a doctor, because there's something seriously fucking wrong with you. Anyway, so this is a timeline, right? There is a timeline, and then there's two timelines. That is what you need to get into your head. There's two timelines in X-Men. So let's start adding the films, right? Let's call this First Class. This is First Class, okay? Nothing changes. First Class is in both timelines. First Class did happen. No matter what film you're watching, whether you're watching the old films, whether you're watching the new films, First Class did happen in both films. Okay? The most pivotal moment is around about here. Okay? This is the pivotal moment. Right? And this is, let's call this day, let's make an abbreviation, let's call it DP. For Days of Future Past. Okay? And this is when the timeline completely splits and it gets very confusing. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through the films, the different timelines, explain, you know, the story of them, and I'm going to point out the major differences, because there's like differences to the originals and the new films, which is basically confusing people. It's the main reason why, basically is the main reason why people are getting confused about these about the film order. And so I'm going to go through one timeline, explain the pivotal differences, and then I'm going to go through the other timeline and can, you know, talk about why how that particular difference is different in the different in the alternative timeline. So I've made a little addition to the timeline in Days of Future Past. By the way, pretty self-explanatory. Like this video is going to contain a shitload of spoilers. So, you know, stop the video now and go and watch the films. If you haven't watched the films, then what are you doing? Spoilers for all the films, okay? All the films, I have warned you. So, right, the pivotal moment in Days of Future Past. Days of Future Past takes place in two places. We'll talk about that later. So when they go back in time, they change a particular event, which spawns these two timelines. And the major event is Tracer is a guy who basically doesn't like mutants, okay? He is played by Peter Dinklage, the dwarf guy, okay? That's who he is. That's who Tracer is. And he figures out a way to use Mystique's mutation to make robots which can literally adapt to any other mutation. So basically indestructible mutant killing robots. And because Tracer dies, his project of mutant killing robots goes in, it kind of, you know, speeds up. It goes fast forward. And with Tracer dead in this timeline, this is when the original films happen, okay? And that, and then basically when Tracer doesn't die, that is where the new films are going. So yeah, so let's deal with the Tracer Dead timeline. Let's call it Tracer Dead timeline. The first film we get in here is Wolverine Origins. Okay, it isn't the first film we get, but it is in, you know, in the kind of order. So Wolverine storyline is very important to understand the differences between these two timelines. This is one of the big differences. Wolverine, he is first seen by Stryker in a firing squad. Okay, no, not in a firing squad, after a firing squad. Him and Wolverine and Victor Logan, what was it called? Bobby Logan and Victor Logan, I guess. They are basically, they do something bad, they get killed, well, they get sentenced to death, and they don't die because of their mutation. And then Stryker's like, these guys are cool, I'm going to make a team with a load of mutants, and we're going to go around doing a load of crazy stuff, basically abducting mutants and getting adamantium. So the difference is that, you know, Stryker and Wolverine are friends in this, kind of briefly for a moment, they're working together in this film, and he gives him the adamantium after he leaves, and then, you know, they plan to get his memory erased, but then he doesn't, but then he does in the end. So that is the difference, that is the big difference. Wolverine is, he escapes, Wolverine escapes, okay? And then he eventually gets, you know, he's in Alaska with, and he finds Rogue. And obviously, what's his name? Magneto is looking for Rogue and accidentally kind of bumps into Wolverine. And this is when we get X-Men 1, okay? This is when the first film starts. So we get the events of X-Men 1. There isn't any, like, any of these really big differences in X-Men 1. So then we get X-Men 2. Now the first big difference between X-Men 2 and this alternative timeline is Nightcrawler. In X-Men 2, we have Nightcrawler. He's pretty much, you know, he's on his own. He's a bit of a, you know, a religious guy. I'm not saying that's a difference, but he's like living on his own in some kind of church here, and he gets brainwashed to assassinate the prior, I need to say Prime Minister, I'm going to obviously say President. So that is one of the big differences. He is on his own, he's living on his own in a church. Okay, that's Nightcrawler. Another thing I forgot to mention is in the Wolverine Origins, the discovery of, well, the way that Scott gets into the X-Men is basically the Stryker and his mutant hunting squad are looking for him, obviously Victor Logan. And they basically find him, get him in, and there's like this concentration camp for mutants that they're testing on and all that kind of thing, and Professor X, like a, I think I'm pretty sure it's a CGI version of Professor X, Patrick Stewart, basically saves all of these captured mutants and takes them, and I think pretty much it's, I don't think it means that these are the first students, but that's basically how the X-Men, you know, in the big house and all that kind of thing, that's how that starts, and that's, well, that is different to the other timeline, which we're going to talk about in a sec. But right now, X-Men 3. Now the big difference here, Jean Grey is not, first of all, isn't a psycho, right? Secondly, she gets killed by Logan, right? Which I think is like probably the greatest dramatical moment in like superhero film history. Anyway, What's-her-face dies. Jean Grey dead. Brown bread. That's it. And then we get Days of Future Past, okay? And in this timeline of Days of Future Past, this is when, well, that's when Days of Future Past, basically, with Tracer dead, we have these ultimate mutant-killing robots. And then the big thing that really needs explaining here is, why the hell is Professor X alive? Why is he alive? Okay, he dies in X-Men 3. Originally, I thought that in this timeline over here, maybe those films, Days of Future Past, was happening over here. I thought that was over here, but that was a complete mistake. Basically, Professor X has a twin. He's a twin, okay? He was born a twin. But because of his telekinetic powers, he basically stole the brain of his twin. And his twin was born completely brain dead. Okay, but for some reason he was kept alive, perhaps for the exact reason I'm going to explain in a bit. Basically, when Professor X dies, his consciousness jumps into his twin. Okay, for some reason he's still in a wheelchair, but maybe something that's maybe That is a bit strange, actually. Why is he in a wheelchair? So I think, yeah, the reason why he's in a wheelchair is something to do with his actual telekinetic power. So basically, he goes into the brain of his twin brother. And that's why at the end of, before Days of Future Past, I always miss their films. There's actually more films than you really realise with these. Okay, the Wolverine. Okay, the Wolverine is, you know, a bit of a subplot. But at the start of Wolverine, we get Logan basically living in a cave on his own. And he's like, you know, he's feeling pretty bad since Jean Grey died. That's where we get these, like, kind of telekinetic dreams between Jean Grey's consciousness after death with the Wolverine. That's how they're selling it. Maybe it is just dreams. But basically, the Wolverine, you know, he's pretty upset about it. And that's why it's kind of obvious that that film happened directly after it. Okay, and then at the end of the Wolverine, after the credits, everything is, like, revealed at the end of the credits. It's like, let's leave the story for, like, the ultimate nerds who, like, watch after the credits, like me. But anyway, at the end of the Wolverine credits, Professor X comes out of nowhere, and it's not, he hasn't been alive. Logan thinks he's dead, okay? He died in the timeline, and, you know, Logan's like, what the hell, why he's still alive? And then, you know, it isn't explained, because it's explained in the film before. But yeah, Professor X and Magneto basically go to Logan and say, you know, we need your help because of these Tracer's robots, because Tracer died, they got these robots. So then Days of Future Past happens with these mutant robots, and the X-Men are fighting these mutant killing robots. And then finally Days of Future Past happens. So I'm going to draw a line. Obviously, they go back in time and they stop Mystique from killing Tracer, which means the keenness to kill mutants isn't as keen, isn't as prominent. And then we get, what do we get here? Yeah, we get, oh, I may as well just put it here. We get X, let's put XA for X-Men Apocalypse. Okay, in an interview, the director, which I'm going to quickly Google. Okay, so the director, Bryan Singer, I'm going to quickly check that again. Bryan Singer. That guy basically said the reason why they've done Days of Future Past is so they can go to this timeline here and do whatever, the quote, something like, whatever the fuck we want. Okay, that's why they've created this alternative timeline. They can mess about with all these old characters that we know and love, and basically what the hell they want. And all the things here, all this here is completely obsolete. It doesn't mean anything. Okay, all this timeline is gone. It's in the past. It doesn't exist anymore. And now we have X-Men Apocalypse, where, you know, things are just going a bit batshit crazy. So, big differences. I've already talked about, so the first difference I was talking about was Wolverine. At the end of Days of Future Past, when this new timeline happens, Wolverine is left at the bottom of the ocean and he basically drowns. But Stryker finds him. He doesn't find him after he's shot by that firing squad. He finds him in this alternative timeline. Basically, what does he do with him? Yeah, because it's confirmed in X-Men Apocalypse. Basically, he is found by Stryker. I don't really think that he was made conscious. I think he was literally just, like, broken down, because he doesn't escape. Okay, in this timeline, in the Tracer Not Killed timeline, Wolverine does not escape. Okay, as early as he does in the other timeline. In X-Men Apocalypse, we find Wolverine basically strapped up to a machine. He's got machines inside his brain and stuff that Stryker's put inside him, and he's literally full on Weapon X mode. He doesn't have any kind of, like, free will of anything. But luckily in X-Men Apocalypse, Jean Grey basically, well, takes the machine off him and sets him free and gives him a few of his memories back with psychic abilities, so, you know, to keep him alive, keep him going. And then we've got that. Okay, so that's that is the first difference. So Wolverine's process to becoming to getting adamantium into his bones is completely different in this timeline. Second difference, which what we're talking about, is Nightcrawler. Nightcrawler in this timeline, Tracer's Not Dead timeline, Nightcrawler is rescued by Mystique. Okay, Mystique is her character completely changes after the events of Days of Future Past, and she becomes, I don't know what you want to call it, really. But basically, she saves Nightcrawler at an early stage, and Nightcrawler joins the X-Men even earlier, when he's basically a kid, which is really cool. Okay, the next difference is Jean Grey. Basically, at the end of Days of Future Past, we get a little insight into the basically this kind of time. So this is like after all these films here, Days of Future Past is set into the future. It's like 2020 or something. We get a little insight into this timeline further on. Okay, so Days of Future Past just happens absolutely fucking everywhere, and it's why this, you know, thing is just so bloody confusing. So we get Days of Future Past here as well, and we see Jean Grey alive, we see Scott alive, and we basically see the X-Men, you know, living in Charles's house, chilling out and having a nice and easy life, hopefully. So we get, which kind of like ruins the whole, this kind of like, because we already know Jean Grey is probably going to survive in these new films, even though they've kind of hinted that Jean Grey is going to go like batshit crazy with a new film. But anyway, this is, you know, Jean Grey is alive and still with Scott and not with Logan, okay? Which is interesting again. So, what else did I say? I think that's pretty much it. And obviously, Charles Xavier doesn't die. He's just, at least he doesn't, I don't think he does. No, well, we don't know yet, that's the thing. And, you know, because we're at this point right now, we don't know what's going to happen. Oh, and obviously I missed the big one. Basically, am I recording? Yeah, am I recording? Yeah, well, these mutant, specialist mutant-killing robots don't exist in this timeline, okay? So, have I explained it well enough? Have I explained everything? I'm pretty sure I have. I'm going to pause for a sec, think for probably about 20 minutes, and think if I've missed anything out. One thing I forgot about, am I recording? Just subconsciously, because it didn't tell me whether I'm actually recording or not. Scott, basically, in the alternative timeline, Scott isn't found by Professor X after the concentration camp that Stryker made. I don't think they even exist. Well, it might exist, we don't really know. Basically, Scott is brothers of one of the X-Men from First Class, and he just basically joins up, like, as if, like, in a pretty normal fashion, and he gets to flirt with Jean Grey a bit, and that's pretty much it. So, yeah. So anyway, what did I just say there? I've been talking for way too long today. If there's any differences that I haven't mentioned, then feel free to leave them in the comment section for other people to read, and tell me what you think about the video. I think it's going to be a seriously long video. But, you know, it has to be, because these films, the timeline is confusing. I don't know why. I think it's just because they left the information about Professor X coming back alive, you know, at the end of the credits for the third film and this Wolverine film. So it's like, at this point, we're like thinking, you know, is Professor X alive or whatever? You're like, how did that happen? And you're thinking it's in a different timeline, but it's not. And that's what I was thinking the other night. I would have made an absolute fool of myself if I didn't watch The Wolverine last night. I would have made a video completely wrong. But anyway, my name is The Metagoblin. Until my next video, ciao.